Hello everyone, I'm going to continue my playthrough of The Wolf Among Us today. Currently we're on episode 3, so let's get started. Oh, I've moved the game to my SSD since the last episode, so the loading time hopefully will be a bit
Our
faster.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the pudding and pie.
My name is Narissa.
Well, Narissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane.
Okay, so I guess starting now.
Fucking creep. Spineless little fucking rat.
Crane? Ugh, God, you think you know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know.
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know,
I think I'm just gonna ignore Beast.
Not now.
I have a
just
right to know.
Him a bit.
My wife is
honey.
Shit!
Crane's been... Whoa, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine, okay? It's going to be fine.
Will someone please explain this to me?
I have to tell Snow what's going on right now.
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap. And I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
The Trip Trap? Are you
Wait, I thought we prevented
right now,
them from taking the body.
They're on their way out.
Bigby!
Okay. Maybe I missed something?
Wait!
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just... Please be careful when you tell her. And you
I
should
know.
Tell her, but...
I know.
No, you don't know.
Yeah,
you
I don't.
Know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
Wonder where we are now. Back at the office? No. Oh. Oh, right, okay. Okay.
I'm honored to be asked to speak to you.
Oh, what's with these controls? They're a bit off. What? I'm pressing A, and I was going to the right. Anything we can look at? Oh, I think the subtitles are off.
I won't offend you by claiming one day that.
Maybe the controls. Wait, what? Okay, never mind.
That the pain of losing Lily will.
There
ever
are no
subside.
Subtitles! What's going on?
I know as well as you that it will never subside. But I also know that.
Okay.
That the memory of
guy?
Lily will sustain as well. And it will...
Your Highness.
Oh, there are some...
Sheriff.
I guess there were no subtitles for her monologue.
I didn't see you there.
Did you know the deceased, Lily?
No, not really. I just came because it... I don't know. Felt like a thing I should do, I guess. I was angry at first when I heard that Lily was getting a funeral. Holly was getting closure. I wanted that too. And I wanted it for Faith. But then I remembered Faith lived a story Lily never did. She had her adventure. She got to live in the light of forever after with me. For a while. So let Lily have the better finish. It all evened it out.
Just gonna say nothing.
Moment of silence. Take care of things, okay?
Okay. Ooh, candles. Oh, table. So look at the liquor. Realize I don't.
Bigby, is everything okay?
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
Settle down, bitch.
Holly, settle down. It'll only take a minute.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here? After you lie, and you say you need her for evidence?
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything.
Oh, there is nobody. I see.
I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this. Holly, it's gonna be okay.
Just say nothing. Look.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help.
Should have seen.
And I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this one isn't on him.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Pay my respects.
Everything okay?
I just came to pay my respects, Holly. I don't mean any harm.
Oh, really? You have no respect you can pay. You don't care about any of us.
Okay, okay, look. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat far away from the ceremony, all right? Look, Holly, I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
Of course. Won't even know I'm here.
Let's discontinue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly. It's your turn to talk.
I know you didn't come here to pay your respects, so whatever it is better be wildly important. It's been hard enough making a connection with these people. When you pull this kind of stuff,
I just say
it just
nothing.
Resets the clock. You drag me away from a funeral, and now you want to pull the lost little kid in a mall routine? Look, I can't read your mind, and I don't really feel like standing here trying, so I'm going back. We'll talk about this later. Snow? Marissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone
Wait, what?
Spoke
Do we...
should really be present for this part.
What are they burning?
She's kind of distraught.
If there's no body.
You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes. I don't mean to be... It's just that something's come up.
We really should go.
And we will, okay? 2 minutes.
No.
This is important, too.
Oh, fine.
How'd it go? At the motel. Did you find anything?
His lips are sealed.
No?
I did. It helped a lot. Thanks.
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
Bastable. Wait, easy now, girl. You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do? That way, it's proper.
Now is really not the time for whatever you Jergovs are planning to do.
Well, isn't that the thing of it? Plans. Except it isn't our plans you should be concerning yourself with. I'm still hurting, you know, from our talk in the cell. And I'll be honest, I'd love nothing more than to carve a sweet poem right into your face for the suffering you've caused me. But I am a professional, and we're here for a job. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere.
Are you working for Crane? Did he send you?
No, see now, you're already asking too many questions. Just pay attention.
I picked that one because I knew that wasn't the case.
So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone, and we leave you to yours?
Yeah, fine.
I'll leave Crane alone. Just get out of here.
Pleasure to hear it.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're happy to report that everything went smoothly. So if you'll just allow us to get out of your hair...
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal?
Mm.
I said all right already. Just go.
And go we shall.
I think we'll keep it. I think we'll keep
it. We won't ruin any more of the wedding or whatever.
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Ollie?
You think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Polly, don't move.
Polly, let me handle this.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hole.
I'm gonna kill you!
Polly!
Oh, boy.
Polly!
Oh.
Ah. I got it, Dom.
Let's kick him. That went great.
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're going to be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy. Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Is she?
She's fine, Bigby. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived, so I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken.
Taking it easy is not really my thing, Doc.
Well, whatever your thing is, try and make it work better for you next time.
Business office. I know, I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then.
About...
Miss White, Bigby?
Because as far as I know, Snow still has no idea. Well, I've been trying to keep it from her.
So, to recap...
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after. We know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
Once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be
easy. Well,
I
guess she must know by now, because...
So, I guess that's the plan, currently.
Otherwise she'd be, like, asking...
I don't know.
...what the deal with Crane is.
That's the plan? Just wait for the mirror?
It's all we have right now. What the hell is going on? Just... I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him, I get it, but do you really think he killed those women?
He killed them, and he sent Dee and Dum to slow me down.
He was a conniver, a coward, a liar, and I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts.
Yep, she knows.
But murdering prostitutes? Ow! Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. I just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did. I'm glad you were there. Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you, but after tonight, it's on my mind.
Ignore her again.
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way, deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, stop pretending.
So what if I do? You think we're broken or something? Is that it?
I don't know. Maybe we're just not cut out for this world. We can't eat each other's hearts anymore, Bigby. This can't be like the old days. We have to make it better.
Guys? We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's,
You waste an hour trying to fix this fucking thing. And it turns out you can't even finish the job.
I tried, all right?
It's okay. It's just... Maybe it's around here somewhere.
No, I'm sure it's not here. I checked every corner. I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
The mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No. We can't depend on the mirror.
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror. We can still solve this ourselves. I know
Never mind that. Come help me look.
Oh boy, here we go. Just random wandering until we trigger the next part of the game. Okay, let's start over here to the left. Oh, don't think there's anything over there. Don't really want to talk to Bufkin. Let's go to his desk. What? Oh. Okay, let's start over here.
What is it?
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
You still haven't told me what was in there.
Oh, so she doesn't know.
I want to know. I need to know.
Whoops. Oh, I
don't
coddle
me, okay?
I guess that's the kind of response I wanted anyway.
There's only so much you can repress, you know?
Snow, you couldn't have known.
No, I could have. Come on, let's keep looking.
Oh, we may as well go through all of them. So, let's have a look at the drawer.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fable Town. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Wait, what? What witch? What meeting?
Well, he called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is. Well, yes, it sounded like the one he got his, glamours from. I'm sure it's about this ring. They must have it.
Why not mention this before?
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. We set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me.
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
I don't know why Snow told you anything.
He and Crane talk all the time, okay? He was a resource, albeit one that turned out to be useless.
We hardly talk all the time. Besides, why spend time on such gutter snipe?
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
You're not needed here.
Just ignore him.
Ignore me?
Look. We know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing.
You're
a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
who
doesn't...
Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years.
I'm heading up the investigation, okay, Bluebeard? That makes this a moot point.
And somebody needs to run the business office while he does so.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours, the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
Yeah. Just point in the direction you want me to check first.
So much bubbling going on.
The glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet.
It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down.
I think we'll...
That has to be our focus.
Go to the office.
I totally chose... I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence.
Bluebeard, just stay out of it, all right? You'll just mess things up further.
I can't get any more messed up.
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now.
So, are we
going?
Where
are you gonna go, Bigby?
Oh, okay. What were the two options again? Oh my god, I forgot. Find the witch. So one of them is to go to their office, and the other
so
one is...
So you leave Crane alone, and we leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
Wait, there's three places I can go to?
No, I'm better off dealing with things.
Oh, right, to his office.
I don't
okay.
need sympathy and I don't need charity.
I'm gonna go to...
Dee and Dumb must know where he is. I should go to their office first.
Perfect. And I'll go to Crane's apartment.
I'll look up their address. I hope you know what you're doing.
Excuse me.
Oh, hi. Sheriff Bigby. Great to see you. I don't know if you remember me. I've, seen you around, but you may have forgotten.
I know who you are, Flycatcher. You've worked at the Woodlands for how many years now?
I think I've lost count. But you know, Crane, let me go recently.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, it's no big deal. So, what brings you here? I mean, can I help you with anything? Are you here to see one of the brothers? D or Dumb?
Have you seen a witch come by?
I don't know. Sometimes.
Really?
But
who is she? Do you know where she lives?
I don't know her name or where she lives, really. She just sometimes drops stuff off for the brothers to deliver.
Deliver to who?
I've never had any reason to see for myself. Sorry.
Okay.
It's been a quiet night so far. I think the twins are out, probably working on a case. Sometimes I don't see them for days. They gave me the job after Crane told me to get lost. He said I was just in the way.
Flycatcher, I'm in a hurry.
Oh, sorry. I was just gonna clean their office next. I can let you in if you want. You can wait for them there.
Sure. Thanks.
No problem.
Oh, I feel like this is gonna
take
a while.
Well, I guess that would be okay.
I wasn't really asking for permission.
Right. You're the sheriff. I just don't want to get in trouble or anything. I'm sure it's fine. I mean, they never told me not to let you in.
Just keep to the back, out of the way, all
right? Right.
All right, here we go.
Let's see if they've got a file on Crane.
Oh, let's have like a donkey skin first. His letters, Faith. Yep.
Crane hired them to look for a photo? So that's why they were at her apartment. And the woodsman's place.
don't know who this guy is, but let's just have a look.
Detective Brannigan. Keep an eye on her.
Okay, let's just cut to the chase, Crane.
Ichabod Crane. He owes the Crooked Man money. Shit. How is he planning to pay this all back? Request for property acquisition. Further details filed under Donkey Skin. Why did he want it back so badly?
Whatever, Cinderella. Let's have a look. Completely irrelevant. And may as well finish it off with beauty.
This is worse than I thought. Shit.
Find anything?
Not what I need.
I know these guys can come off abrasive at times, but they aren't so bad once you get to know them.
I don't think you know
them. They really care about helping people. They're kind of loud at times, but you get used to it.
They only care about helping criminals.
No, I think you got the wrong idea. They help all kinds of people. They're detectives. Anyone can come in here with a problem and they'll do their best to fix it. The way Dee explains it, it's like if someone lost their cat, well, they could hire them to, you know, track it down. Or like sometimes they get packages for people. They can be like couriers, you know?
You mean for people other than the witch?
Oh yeah, all kinds. Come to think of it, I don't really know where they keep them.
Keep what?
Anyways, I'm just saying.
The packages?
You just don't know them like I do.
Sure, flycatcher.
Okay. I'm not gonna talk to him. What is there around here? Okay. So go, may as well loot a little.
You know about this?
No.
Dear Brother D, I think we should get ourselves a dog. Sincerely, Brother Dumb. He actually mailed this?
They do have their quirks.
This is pointless.
See, I knew you wouldn't find anything. Anything of interest, anyways. They're detectives.
Anyways,
like I said,
is not a word.
Just trying to make an honest living.
Just stay out of this. I have work to do.
I'm just saying.
Look, just trust me on this. Tweedledee and Dumb are not nice. They're not helping anyone.
Well, they helped me.
Okay, great. They helped you. That's one person. Now, please, just let me concentrate here.
What am I missing? What requires a lock? Ooh, lollipops. What? Oh, fine. Okay, so I've got a key. Already had a look over here. Oh man. It's probably something on the table. Alright, let's just try everything on the table then.
Dear brother.
Oh god damn it, I already read this.
And you know it, sincerely, brother.
Oh wait, no. This is a different one.
What if you're wrong about them?
Oh, shut up.
I'm not.
And stay out of
the
way.
They're misunderstood, sure, but that doesn't mean everything people say about them is true. I mean, you know, like when I think about it, you guys aren't that different. You help people, and they help people.
Is that what you think?
Bigby?
Shit. There's something here. I know there is. There has to be.
Why would there be anything?
Because they're lying to you, okay, flycatcher? That's why. They aren't detectives. They're somehow involved in the murders, flycatcher. Two fables are dead.
Bigby, what happened to your...
Aw.
You want to know what this is? This is them showing up to Lily's funeral with fucking shotguns!
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Look, Flycatcher, I know you like them, but they're a part of whatever's happening here. They're bad guys. I didn't mean to...
There's a door behind this file cabinet.
Well, I don't
Thank
know
what you. The key back here, but it might be what you're looking for. Well, that key you found should work.
Yeah. Looks like that's all I can do. Shift to run.
JD. A book.
What are you looking for exactly? Maybe I can help.
Anything about Crane. Or the witch he was using. Something. This doesn't really tell us much.
No shit, you didn't even open it to see what it was about. Ooh, what's this? Canned food? Instant.
I'm sorry, I know I'm late. I'll get it to you soon. Ichabod Crane.
Who was he sending money to?
Crooked man. Care of the Lucky Pawn. You know what that is?
Yeah, let's pocket it. Finders keepers? And all that?
Is that what you needed?
I don't think so, but it's interesting. There's more going on here. I still need to find that witch, though.
Okay.
Hey, Bigby. Do you think, after all this, do you think I could come back to the Woodlands? Since Crane let me go. I mean, I can still work here, but...
That's not really my problem.
Right. I know. Sorry.
It's Snow's hair.
Snow White? Why...
We found her hair like this inside Lily's glamour. Anti-Greenleaf. This must be the witch Crane was using.
I guess Dee and Dumb were getting the hair for Crane and sending it to her? That's not a pleasant thought.
There's no address on it.
So what now? Snow would probably want to know about this.
I wonder if Bufkin and Snow had any luck. Maybe they found an address. Or can check for a record on Auntie Greenleaf.
I think I saw a phone near the back.
What, the one I'm standing next to?
You're welcome, Sheriff.
Oh, was I not there already?
This is Snow White.
Hey, Snow.
Oh, it's you. Sorry, I've been answering angry phone calls for hours. People want to know where Crane is. How'd it go with the Tweedle brothers?
No address yet, but I got a name for Crane's witch, Auntie Greenleaf. You heard of her?
No. I'll get Bufkin started looking for a record, but it might take some time.
Huh. Somebody's got to know where to find her. And Snow, I found a note with some money attached. Crane has been embezzling from Fabled Town.
Of course. Because why half-ass being a complete sleazeball? Do you think this is tied to the murders? I mean, I guess it doesn't matter.
Right now, I honestly don't care. I just want to get the fucking guy.
You might want to try Holly's place. See if she hasn't burned Lily's things yet. Or Crane's. You might find something there.
Although I can go ahead to Crane's next.
I'll leave it up to you, but we don't have much time. Crane is meeting her at 2 a.m.
I'll go to Crane's apartment, see if there's an address or something there.
Okay. I'll give Bufkin a name and hope you find something in the record.
I don't know for sure, but I feel like going to Crane's apartment is going to be a complete waste of time. But
I hope you'll do the same.
I don't think I've ever seen...
We'll catch him, Snow.
Like,
I have to go. Someone just...
I don't think I've seen any playthroughs where people went to his apartment. Or I don't record, at least, having any significance. But I'm going to go just have a look.
Bluebeard burned everything.
Why would he burn the... Oh, fuck's sakes. Detective 101.
I tried to stop him, but I got here too late. He wouldn't listen to me. Threatened to strangle me if I got too close. There was nothing I could do. Honest.
So you stood around while Bluebeard ransacked the place, huh? What good are you anyway if you can't even... Useless monkey.
Awesome. Why am I wasting my time here? Is any of this stuff gonna show anything?
If there was something here I could use to find him, there isn't now. A waste of fucking time.
What now? Did the Tweedle brothers have any information about the witch?
Just her name, Auntie Greenleaf. You heard of her?
No, that's strange. I can check the books for you.
How long is that gonna take?
If I haven't come across her name before, she's not going to be very easy to track down.
We'll head over to the Trip Trap. Maybe I can get some information from Holly. What?
After what happened at the funeral, she may not be too happy about seeing you.
It's her fault.
Hey, Holly started it. I was just trying to make sure the fight didn't get any worse.
If you say so. I'd better go fill Miss White in on the circumstances.
I knew this was going to be a waste
She's
of time.
She's going to be very disappointed.
Good luck.
So, that's all the game let me interact with. Server closed due to...
She's asleep, you fucking idiot. We're closed.
Yes, that's the best way to get into a closed wall. Just don't say anything.
Read the sign! Hey!
Hey, look, Woody, it's the sheriff. Well, come on in, buddy.
Brent.
What? He's a traveler. A weary traveler in search of some hospitality, right?
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
I want a drink. Anybody else want a drink?
Brent... Swinehart said you shouldn't mix
you
it
You think
with...
I give a fuck what that fucking guy says? Or what you say?
Brent, really, you shouldn't drink right now. You should quit while you're ahead with that stuff. I might need your help.
Holly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really?
The doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia. For the pain.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep, like I am right now, it gives you a very, very, very nice high.
He's gonna pass out.
He shouldn't mix it with alcohol.
Yes, he did. Certainly did. But let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time, fat boy.
I'm after Crane, all right? The guy we all hate? And there's a time limit here, so try and focus for a minute.
Crane?
We'll get to whatever you're here for in a sec.
Wait, was he even at the funeral?
Funeral back there? That was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
Yeah.
You weren't fucking there.
Oh, right.
Talking to Biggie now, okay? Can't say you being there helped things much.
Ren, don't start nothing.
Who's starting anything?
You didn't exactly help things by charging in like that.
Oh, yeah. Wait, what's that called? Blaming the victim? Something? Holly and I were the ones that got shot.
So did I.
Whatever. It's all right. I'm too out of it to get into it. I want to clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all gonna have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. Look through Lily's belongings and get out of here.
Yeah, yeah, I know, I know. And I want to help you, okay? And I will. But first, indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds. As a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Grand Bigby didn't come here to get loaded.
I don't want to get loaded with him.
Yeah, sure, why not? That's true.
To the dead.
All right, now help me.
Oh, his...
Doc said you needed to rest.
How many times you fucking gonna warn me about it, huh? You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back!
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it, it's done!
Probably not gonna last very long, anyway.
What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
I don't want anything from you, Woody.
What is the problem here? What stupid shit will you both not let go of?
Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking lard cake with Pay and Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly had to find out going through all of her sister's shit. What fun that must have been. Trick after trick of this fat ass and Lily.
I didn't plan for that, all right? And our thing, whatever it was, it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't. I never fucked her when she was snowing. I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out. And you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
You know what? Fuck this. I don't need this shit.
Oh yeah, that's it. Now you're teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants. I don't give a shit.
No, that's okay, because I'll tell you what he thinks.
Wait, wait. I've got some questions for you.
What possible questions could you have for this piece of shit? Everything's a problem when I want to talk, but when the woodsman's about to leave, it's, oh wait, I have questions.
What do you want?
Tweedledee came in here 2 nights ago. Why'd you run?
I was scared, okay? I didn't want to go down for something I didn't do. I never would have hurt that girl, Bigby.
All right.
Is that it? Causing so much drama.
I don't know where Lily's shit is. Check Holly's room, I don't know. But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the rule.
You're such a waste of fucking...
Actually, Bigby, if you'll excuse me, it seems that I'm gonna pass out. What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
Have a good night. Gren won't remember this. I don't know why, but I always like going to the left, seeing what there is. What if I kick it again? Oh, there we go. Can we do it a third time? Oh, no. Okay. Oh, I guess we actually had to do that.
Bigby, bar's closed. And excuse me, but I'm not in the mood for entertaining. But what the fuck? I know you're not gonna leave. You do what you want. You always do what you want.
Okay.
Do you even give a shit about us? The strays? The ones that aren't in that fancy high rise. Those of us that gotta work for a living.
Holly, just because I live in the woodlands doesn't mean I'm not one of your strays. I'm not Crane or Cole. I didn't exactly grow up wearing clothes.
Yeah, I know you didn't.
Wait, so that's Faith, Nerissa, and...
Why'd you even come here?
Who was the one on the road?
There's nothing here to investigate.
Oh, I guess that would've been...
I can't be any use to you.
Lily? I don't know.
I need to, look through your sister's things.
To look for clues?
If you want to put it that way.
Yeah, who's this person? Was that Lily? I don't know. Whatever. Let's have a look at the glamour. Wait, is this the one? I think that's the same one as before. So I guess we don't really need to look at the brooch either. Oh, here we go, so...
Be honest, Sheriff. Why are you going after him? The guy that killed Lily. You could have quit a long time ago, but you're still going. Why? Did they give you this job for a reason? Or was this the only thing the business office would let you do?
The guy I think did it? He and I have a history.
A schoolyard grudge ain't a reason, Bigby. At least it ain't a good one. You just remember, whatever bullshit excuse you tell yourself, I'm counting on you. So don't have any more fuck-ups.
You're getting your glamour on this day. One of these has to be the witch. Auntie Greenleaf. Gotcha.
Hello, this is Snow White calling. I'm looking for Bigby. Is anyone there? Bigby, if you're there, pick up, okay?
Snow?
Oh, thank God. Tell me you found something.
I got it, Snow. Her address was here with Lily's things. It's on, White Plains Avenue, 1284. It's an apartment complex.
Great. Let's get going. Crane's meeting her in a few minutes. Listen, we have to hurry. I'll meet you down there.
I'm confused. Right. Why would she have the contact details of Auntie Greenleaf? Because wasn't she getting the glamour for Snow through Crane?
Bigby! I just got here.
Yeah, me too. It's number 23. I haven't seen it yet.
We're late.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, of course. I mean, she...
This is it.
Alright.
Maybe she just gets illegal glamours directly from her. I don't know. Okay, let's just charge in, because I don't see the point.
Wait. What are you doing?
What does it look like?
Don't just kick it in. We don't know what's on the other side. Let's just save the last resort for last.
No.
Ah! Oh my god! I'm sorry! Don't hurt me! We are so sorry. We didn't realize you were right there.
Where's Crane? Is he hiding in here? Has he left?
I'm sorry. It's all right. It's okay. Calm down. We're not here to hurt you.
Are you sure?
Yes, Mr. Wolf can get a bit excited sometimes, but that's all over with now, I assure you. Now, what's your name?
Rachel. Who are you? Just so...
Deary, I'm the big bad wolf.
Bigby.
Wow. I've heard about you.
Have you?
All about how the woodsman cut you open, fed you rocks for dinner, and then threw you into the ocean. And you can't even swim! Did it leave a scar? Can I see it? Are you and the woodsman friends? I heard somewhere that you guys are friends.
Okay, kid. Look, I'll make you a deal. If you're good, I'll give you a whole demonstration. I'll be me, and you'll be the grandmother. Though, I don't know if Miss White here would necessarily approve.
Okay. Deal. Is there anything you need?
We're looking for a man. A skinny, pale, nervous fella. Have you seen him?
My art teacher says men are a waste of time.
Do you go to school?
Sometimes. Is there something you want?
Well, this has all been thoroughly enlightening, but I'm still gonna have to search the apartment, so... Step aside, kid.
Wait, please! I don't know if I'm allowed!
Oh, it's okay. Really. We'll be very quick, and he won't touch anything.
Not true.
I've been here all night. Nobody's been here!
I'm on to you.
Okay, Mr. Wolf. I'm gonna trust you not to break anything. Don't get me in trouble.
What are we looking for specifically?
Something to break.
You could still be here.
Okay, I think I know where to go directly, so I'm not gonna waste any time. So where was that disc that I was just looking at?
No one's been over all
okay,
night.
I don't know where I'm going.
Just going to check.
What's this?
It'll only take a moment.
Record player. Oh, I wanted to go to this disc. Here we go. Get out of the way.
How much longer do you think it'll be?
Fine. I'm gonna check out this room first.
The Butcher.
What's that?
A package having to do with someone called the Butcher. It's empty. Not here.
There's no one here but me. Where do you buy your clothes?
At a store? Oh.
My mommy makes all of mine.
Oh, here we go.
What is this?
Mommy uses that to carve her trinkets. It's from the old world.
Trinkets? Like glamours?
Nothing that looks like Crane was here either.
Nothing?
See? I saw a spider over there.
It's pretty rare to see a burner like this.
Dowdy. That's how we like it. Do you like broccoli?
Not really.
Your mom a hunter?
Oh no, she never... That was found in the woods around Dick's Mountain, I think.
Oh my god, how do I get it to talk?
Big band or classical?
Oh.
Honky tonk.
No accounting for taste.
There's the photo up here. I think that's what we need.
That your mom?
Nope. Okay. I guess we need it. Oh, what's this?
Do you have any...
Oh my god, I could have done that from the start. I know.
Damn it.
Shouldn't say that.
Nothing.
I keep getting whiffs of that aftershave of his.
I do too.
Can I go to bed now, please?
Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried. Oh, no, 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 no. Please, 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 just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
that. It's all right, honey. Bigby's not going to break it.
You don't understand. She will freak out if she discovers I've let people in here and let them touch her stuff, okay? She checks all the time to see if things move. I don't want to get in trouble.
Look, I have to check this out. I'm sorry.
No! Put it down! Please, don't! This isn't what you think! You gotta believe me! The guy isn't here, I promise!
It's gonna be okay, Rachel.
Please, I'm begging you. I don't wanna get in trouble.
Too bad.
Anti-green leaf.
It hurts when you do it that fast. What? Not sprightly enough?
You picked the wrong night to lie to me. No more lying, no more ring around the rosy, no more bullshit non sequiturs. You're done. It's over. You'll tell me what I want to know right now.
All right, start explaining. And from the beginning. I was born in the woods to a jackal and a... Not that. Where is Crane? What was his plan?
How am I supposed to know? He came, he went, like all young lads.
You have to know something.
Unless you want a recipe for owl stew.
Don't you fucking lie to her either. I don't think you get it. I'll gladly illustrate how much trouble you're in if you keep up the babe in the woods routine.
I have a lot of bullies in my life, Mr. Wolf. One more won't tip the kettle. There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Whatever it is, Greenleaf, whatever it is that's keeping you from saying something...
I don't give a shit about your problems, Greenleaf. Just talk, now.
You have no idea what's going on, do you?
Okay, you know what I think? I think we've been more than patient with you. This witch has been selling illegal glamours that continue to undermine everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap if she's afraid for her life. We can at least make sure she never hurts us again. We're destroying the tree.
No!
So this is a choice.
How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing
that... I think I've generally seen other people not burn it, and then you can...
That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole.
And then you can make her work for you.
And the
towards,
who can't afford the glamours
like,
from
eventually
you
she'll
come to me for
work
help.
For you, I
without
guess.
Them, where do you think they could
don't
go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's
but
misery. Two fables are dead because of this crap.
I don't think I've seen
it's
anyone burn it, so I think
you
that's
think
what
I like
do.
Being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old hags like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
Very different means to handle it, too.
And I don't use it as an excuse to wreck people's lives.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but please, don't do this.
Sorry, the tree has to go.
Look, I'll tell you what's going on, just don't burn my tree. The Crane was here, okay? He was here and he left. He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
What does the ring do?
He thinks it's the ring of despair. You know, that will pierce the protection around the girl's speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence. It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago. Just please, you can catch him if you leave, okay? Just leave, and don't Don't burn my tree.
Bigby, where are you going?
Hey, Greenleaf. Don't think this is over.
Wait, seriously?
I won't.
I didn't even get a chance to burn it. Well, I guess there was one part in the dialogue, but, whatever. Damn. I wanted to see it go up in flames. I think this is the last part of this episode, so there's not too long to go.
No, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with. I don't think so, at least.
Shit.
Hold on. Sheriff, is there something more I can help you with? Decided you want a taste of the wares? Oh, I see. Come to audition, you bitch.
Get out of the way.
I'm in your way, love.
Hey, you can't just go in there.
We have a problem.
Tell me who did it. Just tell me who did it. I know you know.
Mr. Crane, please. She can't help.
I know you know what the plan is. I won't be held accountable for this.
I can't. I'm sorry.
You both know what's going on. Just tell me.
Crane, get away from them.
I didn't do anything. I promise you, I didn't do anything. These girls. The girls, they'll back me up. I just have to get the stupid ring working, that's all. I can't talk because of that spell. But once this ring gets through, I'll know what's going on and this whole thing will be over. That's all. Please. I'm innocent. Completely, completely innocent.
No one's ever talked their way out of an execution, Crane.
No, really. This will work, I tell you.
When did we talk about an execution of any sort?
Damn you, come on. Please. Tell me who killed her.
My lips are sealed.
How many years?
What?
How many years has this been going on?
Too many. But I didn't kill those women, Bigby. Please, I had nothing to do with that. Oh, God.
You screwed up, Crane.
Bigby, Sheriff, listen.
The amount of evidence I have, the town wouldn't bat an eye if I were to throw you down the witching well tonight.
Please, Sheriff, I'm telling you the truth when I say that I did not kill that woman.
Bigby, I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women? He wouldn't be brave enough.
Yes.
No, of course he's guilty. If you'd seen the room...
I don't need to see the room.
There's a lot he has to answer for.
There's a lot we all have to answer for.
This is different, Snow, and you know it.
You said you found evidence of him defrauding Fable Town, of using our money for his own ambitions. That's one thing. But don't you have doubts he's a murderer? We've both known him for so long.
I can't believe I'm hearing this.
No, Snow. I have no doubt. He's the killer.
But why? Really? Think about it. Because circumstantial evidence is one thing. And I won't kill a man for that.
I didn't intend for any of this to get so...
You've been stealing money from Fabletown for years, haven't you? Yeah. We're not gonna kill you, so quit your shivering.
I never said that.
Ichabod Crane, you are under arrest for the misappropriation of Fabletown funds. You have the right to counsel, the right to depose witnesses...
And for suspicion of murder.
No, Sherry. This can't be Greenleaf again and again, behaving however you like, acting without constraint. You have to respect this office, Bigby, and you have to respect me as its leader, starting now.
You think you have what it takes to run that office? You think I didn't make sacrifices? I made sacrifices. And you won't be in that chair 1 minute before you have to give up someone you care about just so the wheels don't fall off the goddamn wagon.
I did the best I could with what I had. And the town took everything it could out of me.
Better save your energy, huh? You've gone
Wait,
away
we
for
have a prison?
Long time.
What prison? I don't know. I don't get it. Oh well.
What are you saying?
What you got there? Look, it's recently come under our attention that you're, how shall I put this, attempting to claim what is the personal property of the Crooked Man. He's about yay high, 120 odd pounds, pissed his sheets until he was 14. Sound familiar?
I haven't told him anything.
Not now, not now. Shh. The grown-ups are talking. Guys, speak English?
No.
You're interfering with Fabletown business.
No. That's not how this works. How this works is you are going to walk Crane over here, like a good doggy.
It wasn't my fault.
Shut up. You're interfering with official Fabletown business. Step aside.
Tweedledee, what's the, you know, that thing the Mundys call me?
What?
My nickname. You know what I'm talking about.
Bloody Mary,
that's it. Thank you. And do you know why they call me that? Because some of them, they think it's funny to have their little sleepovers and go into their little bathrooms and say my name 5 times in the mirror. They find it less funny when I actually show up and feed their lungs to the family dog. And I do that for a hobby. Like golf, to relax.
This was really the wrong day to try and pull this shit.
I told you he'd never just give him up.
Fuck it.
Oh, I hit A just in time. So that was the only quick time event in this entire episode. And it was essentially pointless.
Bigby?
Oh no, here we go. There's more. Q. What am I? Oh, there we go. What a beast. Anderson, am I doing something wrong? What the hell is happening? Oh, here we go. I can take his life here. Correctly. Oh, one of those. I think. I think I'll be merciful, as much as I'd like to see the beheading of him. I'm a good guy.
Just didn't know when to end. You know, you would think silver bullets would work on anything but a pure werewolf. But as it turns out, it's just ridiculous. Right, Wolfie? I mean, hey, look, I know it sounds ridiculous, but really, guys, can you argue with these results? Because I know I can't.
Come on.
Wait! Stop!
No, don't do it.
Just take him, okay? Take Crane. Just stop, please.
Yeah, I don't know.
Snow, don't do this.
It's your lucky day, kid. The crooked man says it's okay with him. Hello, Ichabod. Got a stomach ache? Oh, and just between us girls, Crane ain't no killer. I mean, look at his face. Couldn't stick a pig if his life depended. Kinda like your boyfriend here. Too pussy to ruin a Tweedle's day. Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. I'm jazzed about it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen. I'm sure we'll be in touch. See you around.
And that's the end of episode 3, I believe. Next time on The Wolf Among Us.
He's lucky to be alive, and he won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
This is getting worse by the minute. We don't have time to sit around and wait for their next move.
I'll get things under control.
Woody? I'm not gonna tell you again.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you.
What do you want to talk about?
I just wanted to... about last night.
After what they did to you, are you even gonna be able to stop them?
Don't hold out on me, Jack. You've always got some angle.
Not this time. I know when a mark's not worth the trouble. Do you?
Don't make me come down there to deal with you. I don't want it. You don't want it. Then again, you don't have much choice at this point, do you?
And this is where we get to see... man. Okay. I wanted to burn her tree down so badly, and it didn't let me. So sad. Okay, so that's been episode 3 of The Wolf Among Us. I guess, obviously, next time we'll continue with episode 4. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.